I'm so curious. What's one thing on your mind that you want to talk about often?
Nikiwa tu peke yangu kwenye nataka gatu ni niongea about ni watoto. Si watoto.
Watoto.
Kids.
Okay.
Yes, I get this. Let me ask you this since we're talking about kids. We see different celebrities from all around the world naming their kids in weird type of ways. Wanawafungulia Instagram, nini nini. Is your method of parenting the same way when ikikuja ku naming their children? Is it lazima ikuwe kwa family ama unataka uende out there, you know?
Aye, mi kwanza ni too cultural. So lazima mtoto wangu akuwe na like cultural names hata before hizi zingine.
Nice.
Hadi niko too cultural za zingine na wishi gisinge kuwa na Christian name.
Ah, ungekuwa zote tu ni za huko.
Naweza ambia budangu hiyo time buda chorea hiyo jina sitambue mimi. Alafu hii kwa kato hii IG kuwafungulia mapage siko kwa support ya hiyo cause mazee IG kuna wase wengine very weird.
True that.
Wase wengi wamekuwa hurt over like social media from bullying ama wase kutumia image yako for something else.
Yeah, true that.
Mamemes, sahi kuna mamemes zinatengenezwa mpaka za videos zenye zinaka real. Unaona?
Yeah.
So I think for a kid who ana yo control at that point, inafaa umwache afike hiyo level, ajichagulie na umguide.
Nice.
When that time comes, when they're like 18.
Yeah.
Now, we usually do something on the show here called the warm-up, kuchangamsha tu kidogo. Kuna kikombe hapo mbele, kuna maswali. It's the fun edition. Hakuna kitu crazy.
Yeah,
there might be.
Ni new ama imekuaga.
Imekuaga, manze, tulitubia jana, wacha tukue honest.
Was Kenyan male in high school. Sasa hapa ndo sa mengoo ya.
Kwa nini?
Jumi maze, misi kwa boarding do.
Walai, nilikuwa day scholar.
Nilikuwa day scholar, nilikuwa national into Kibera Glory High School. Kwa line saba. So lunch tukuwa nakula kwa mburu.
Nice.
Na dinner tunakula mtaani.
Alafu hii lunch ni nini ilikuwa ya ni inaku? Yani ukifikiria ile lunch ya pali, nini ilikuwa inakufanya excited sana? Hapo kwa mburu.
One kulikuwa na chapati ya 15 bob inakuja na avocado na waru top layer ukifika mapema
so ukifika mapema
inaingia 12:45 ndio hapo by 12:50
imeisha
unapata top layer
oh.
Inakuja na avocado so unajua sasa kwa na rush pale juu only 5 minutes
timing muhimu
so manze hiyo ilikuwa kaka Christmas
nice hiyo ilikuwa imebamba.
What artist has inspired you the most?
Joy 2019 to me.
In 2019 ama in general?
In general.
Oh yeah, what's happening in general, yeah.
I think just in general, in the last niseme, venye trap ilizaliwa.
Nice.
Before that, was all kwa inspire kwa kiasi, kwa like, kitu siwa.
Okay.
That's when nikianza,
yes.
To a certain level. Ikafika sana, nimegrow yo level yenye inspiration yake ilifika. So naanza kutafuta wasi wengine. But neza sema Young Thug.
Ah, nice. I like that because Tory Lanez recently, when he's doing his album tour, he's just said that many hip-hop artists in the States can attribute their sound and their style of rapping to Young Thug, but not many people give it up to him. Exactly.
Young Thug alini challenge kukua ebo kwanza kutry melodies in like music. And the first song we try now ilikuwa kumaka normally I was not rapping.
Yeah.
Nilikuwa na rap, nika naimba, ukiona Kanye, the last verse naimba, ukiona ngoma ka stay, naimba yote. So, alinifanya nikuwe hiyo uncomfortable that, even people with deep voices can actually just go and
do their thing.
If you have a melody, you just have to create a melody.
Okay.
It doesn't matter, unaweza imba.
Nice.
Well, how does your hairdresser, wewe unaenda kana ka Pinterest board, ama unaenda kana ka nini?
Ni anto kwanza, Mama Brinyo.
Shout out to
Mama Brinyo. Out ya Kibera number 8.
Kabisa.
So yeye ndo kamna hizi my idea.
Nice.
Wacha.
Mimi naenda gatu hapa na niambia si ujaribu hii.
Wow.
Kaka smart.
Yeah, ni kali.
Trust women, you know? So
trust women, man.
You've had like a very interesting career journey.
Yeah.
You've had controversial moments, you've had outspoken moments. Now there is a new crop of artists women ingia game. Umekolabo na one of them, Sailors. And everybody's talking about, you know, the lyrics.
Yeah.
What's your take on it, especially, you know, with the fact that you're collaborating with the younger generation now?
It's amazing.
Okay.
Yeah,
especially with ethic?
Everyone.
Okay.
I think it's they're not doing anything that the guys didn't do before. The Noninis, the Juakalis, they did it. The way Kamu eras. So why is it hard for them? They're just doing it on different, it's more, it's taken to another level.
Okay.
And it's a conversation that needs to be had. It's because even during the the Nonini era, mm-hmm. when they were doing the Wekamu ones, people didn't actually have a conversation. So it just came like, was like for cool middle and underground guys, mm-hmm. and then ikapotea. But still until today, in, even in school or anywhere, people don't want to talk about drugs and people don't want to talk about sex.
Mm-hmm.
And this is what these kids are talking about, actually their life. For the first time, we have artists mm-hmm. in an era where they're talking about the real thing that mm-hmm. is happening and they're doing. Not like us where we used to be like, I want to drive a Lamborghini, you know, like Abado. I have to package it mm. And do all this choreography on my lyrics. For them, just like, I woke up like this and I was like mm-hmm. feeling like this, then I smoke a
mm-hmm.
joint.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So for me, it's the best time that people now should actually, especially parents,
okay.
realize like, oh, we actually need to start talking about this stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Because what are the parents, even until now, the parents are just keeping quiet like, this mm-hmm. is not happening.
Mm-hmm.
It's happening.
True.
The kids are doing drugs. Mm-hmm. The kids are having sex.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Nobody wants to talk about it. People are just saying like, oh, this is not content. This is the best content.
With that being said, when you worked with Sailors, how was the writing process of the song?
It was very simple. Like, first, the young guy had like 12 choruses.
Miracle Baby.
Yeah, then I was like, okay, no, I think I'm going with Wakiritho.
So he had others.
Even Nyandus was part of my chorus. Even Nyandus was part of my chorus. And I was like, I needed something cultural but urban.
Yeah.
Like it when I had Wakiritho the first time, he just dropped the chorus, the first thing that flipped in my mind was that Banco Twitch era, you know.
Like
urbanizing. True. A cultural word, not a Sheng word, mm-hmm. not like a Swahili word, like true. But cultural word. So I was like, yeah, we're going with that one.
Yeah,
I wanted them to also feel as comfortable because I was taking them on a different type of beat.
True mm-hmm. that.
And I didn't want to be too harsh on them, but I wanted mm-hmm. them to be themselves
yeah.
in my beat.
Yeah.
So I tell them, no, we are doing both. So nice. Let's go.
I like that. And talking about doing both and Kwenda, one thing that drove people crazy online is the fact that Akukwa na was super kwa hii video.
Eh, mazetu tulichuja waresh.
Kwa nini? We are worthy. We are queens. Kwa
najua Sailors ni kuinama na nini.
Ilikuwa to the song was too gangster.
Yes. How does Octo get to this point where you're so calculated and you want everything to mesh, you want the song not to be released the next day, you want a video to look a certain way? How does Octo get to this train of thought? Unajua kutoka mbali manze tumeanza kutoka siku zile tulikuwa tuna shoot video na green screen, unajua mpaka sasa hivi pale tuko manze tuna shoot video worth hundreds of thousands, unajua. Mm-hmm. How do you get to that point as an artist?
I think once you've realized like you're in business, once you realize like this is not just for fun, like
okay.
I'm not just having a good time, I'm not just I cannot just rap, like yes, I've done like dope verses, what else can I do? Like if somebody was to mute this song when they're watching it, will they still vibe to it?
Ah,
you know, like
okay.
wow.
if like I want them to be entertained even on mute.
Oh,
you know, like I want to have like a feeling on every project. So when you get to that level, you start like investing differently. And and then when I drop music, like I look at who am I partnering with. I want to be in the right playlist. So
okay.
when I'm selecting like the beat, is like which playlist am I targeting for this season? Like so like when we drop Wakiritho, was a partnership with like one big streaming company called Audiomack.
Nice.
You know, and it was like 2 days exclusive on their platform before I can put it on any other platform.
Nice.
That creates a buzz on streaming and also a buzz on different playlists that I would have never got if I was just like dropping it like, hey, let's just drop a song.
Let's just drop a song. True.
Yeah. So with Spotify and any streaming thing, like I always check like, okay, every Friday the playlists are being updated.
Mm-hmm.
Who's dropping songs on that day? If I get in that playlist, like now Barnaboy was dropping, I knew Barnaboy was dropping a song before even anybody knew was dropping a song, and I knew it was going to be on that playlist, and I tell them I want to be on that playlist.
Okay.
You know, so when you listen to Barnaboy, the next is Wakiritho. Mm. So if you've never heard about me, you start Googling.
Yes.
And you start researching more. So it's not about this one specific song, but now the whole catalog.
Nah.
People should stop looking at music, reaching, like, having a million views being a success in music.
Okay. Like, that's the stereotype we need to change.
Yeah, like the songs that actually made me Octo, but wasn't a Kimbioko, Ivo Ivo, because you can do 200,000 views. You may make a Domob Kliko, Semi Oli Elenikona, 2.9 million views.
Okay. I guess
it's not about the views.
Or the
just do music and you want to join it.
Yeah.
I always tell artists, you need 1,000 loyal fans. You don't need 1 million. 1,000. Ukitua kiberiti, wananunua.
Okay.
Ukitua t-shirt, wananunua. Ukitua viatu, wananunua. And you will not need anyone. A 1,000 loyal people.
Mm.
Only. Ukitua album. Those 1,000 people can make you trend, can put you in the right playlist, everything.
Which other ways are you looking to diversify your brand? Because you've done a lot of work with NGOs. Mm-hmm. You've done a lot of work with partnering with other artists. So which are other ways you're expanding your brand?
But no, now mostly I'm going like fashion and like apps.
Mm.
So there's guys we've been working on. We dropped another app that is more minimal. For like people's mental health, because you may realize or say wengi jo social media ime let a social community kwa phones, but ime nyanganya the real
interactions
one on one.